When I first started teaching in the mid-1980s, the use of hypnosis was limited to doctors and psychologists. There were societies set up in the UK specifically to actually limit the use of hypnosis to just these professions. I thought this was terrible. I'd already been in practice for 10 years as an Ericksonian hypnotherapist, and I knew that hypnosis could benefit many people if released from the clutches of these elitists. I knew it could easily be employed indirectly within all of the caring professions and therefore help many patients and clients. So, I set out to challenge the authorities and establish my courses in over 20 hospitals and universities. My students were social workers, occupational therapists, speech therapists, nurses, counselors, you name it, all of the healthcare professionals that have the opportunity to make a genuine difference to the lives of their patients and their clients. That was my audience. They're the people I wanted to train, not just doctors and dentists and psychologists. We had our graduates go back into their respective professions and use their hypnosis skills indirectly, often integrated with their areas of specialization. So slowly, we infiltrated the medical profession. And now, our approach to hypnotherapy is used right across the medical field. So compassionate hypnotherapy has come a long way, thanks mainly to the thousands of students we've taught over the years, and my determination to also make a difference to the lives of others.